for decades, it sat in a Minnesota basement gathering dust, its owners unaware what they had.
As Boyd Hooper reports, that long hidden treasure is about to make big news halfway around the world.
Curiosity.
Coming up.
It's been the fuel for Sam Traxler's interest in the martial arts.
I did basic training in Fort Sill, Oklahoma. That's where I was originally introduced to it by my drill instructors.
Coming through.
Curiosity about jiu-jitsu.
We're here.
It's Japanese roots.
Even the best black belt is still learning.
And a curious item Sam's father had hanging on his wall. That's him.
This is it, guys.
Jeff Traxler, Sam's dad. And this is what he thought was a World War II Japanese sword.
So growing up, I always saw it on the wall. So I'm only 24, so he's had it most of my life.
Jeff Fowler, and his father is the one that brought it back.
Yeah,
that's Jeff Fowler. And this is his father, who brought the sword home to Minnesota as a souvenir of his service in Asia during World War II.
When you were growing up, where was it in the house?
In a basement, in a cellar, with canned goods and other things.
Just sitting there?
Just sitting there, yep. Lay there and nobody really cared about it.
And when Jeff's dad died?
It almost ended up in a burn pit.
Seriously?
Yep, seriously.
Instead, Jeff gave the sword to his friend.
I traded some work with him.
Jeff Traxler.
He brought it out and showed it to me and he says, you can have it. I says, well, I got to do something for you. So I dug a septic system with a backhoe for him.
The septic system that put the sword on Jeff Traxler's wall, where his son, who'd learned jiu-jitsu in the Army, became curious about the sword's Japanese characters.
Really, we had no idea what we were getting into.
After which, Sam and his girlfriend, Allie, found this nifty translation page on Reddit.
Dropped it in here just to see if someone could translate it.
Someone like Yano Takashi, who saw on Reddit the characters from the sword and had news for Sam and Allie.
It's become bigger than we ever imagined.
The sword wasn't from World War II, but belonged to a samurai between 400 and 500 years ago.
You know, when you think about this metal and 500 years, it's hard to comprehend it.
Yet there was the proof for anyone who could read it, the family crest, the markings of a specific Japanese blacksmith, even a wooden tag with a family name and address.
Wow, I had no idea.
But how did Jeff Fowler's dad get it?
We don't know how he got it, yeah. He's just never talked about it.
Here's that picture.
They have learned at war's end, tens of thousands of Japanese swords were confiscated and destroyed by American troops. Some found their way, tucked in soldiers' duffel bags, to America. But what to do with this one?
What a great opportunity.
Now that the Traxlers know what they have, maybe have it appraised, then sell it.
That's not our way.
Makes no difference if that was worth $100,000 or whatever it's worth. It doesn't matter. It has to go back to where it came from.
But how?
There we go. Hi.
Hey, Yano.
Hello.
Yano, the man who responded to the Reddit post, has taken care of it all. The website, the fundraising, and the plane tickets to fly Sam and Allie to Japan later this month to deliver the sword to the descendants of its previous owner, who will donate it to a museum in the town from which it came. A big deal.
I guess Sam and Ali gonna be the TV star in Japan.
For 75 years, a Japanese treasure has been hiding in Minnesota, taken from an enemy.
This is the chestnut butt.
Going back.
Amazing.
To new friends.
I'm so excited.
You come here maybe someday. If you come when it's cold, we'll take you driving on the lakes and go fishing through the ice.
Boyd Hooper.
Whoa.
KARE 11 News.
All right, my friend.
Lee Satter.
Sam and Allie will be delivering the sword to Japan end of this month. A grand reception is planned, we're told, and they have promised to share pictures and video with us, which I know Boyd will be happy to share with all of you. How incredible. We need to send
I'm sure he would love to go.
Unbelievable treasure, right? I mean, you have this sort of like relic or whatever, this spoil of war sitting there, and you think it's from the war, and then later to find out it's 500 years old from a master blacksmith.
Why, everyone go through their basements.
Right?
I don't know that any of us would be that lucky to find something
that's
that
amazing.
A lot of junk in mine.
Yeah.
How good of them to return it too. Right,
good people.
High road.